Hare Krishna, Sri Ishopanishad, Mantra 11. Vidyam cha vidyam cha yastad vedo bhayam saha avidyaya mrityam tirtva vidyaya mritam ashnute. Synonyms: vidyam, knowledge in fact, cha and avidyam, nascence, cha and ya, a person who, tat, that, Veda knows, ubhayam, both, saha, simultaneously, avidyaya, by culture of nascence, mrityum, repeated death, tirtva, transcending, vidyaya, by culture of knowledge, amritam, deathlessness, ashnute, enjoys. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Only one who can learn the process of nascence and that of transcendental knowledge side by side can transcend the influence of repeated birth and death and enjoy the full blessings of immortality. Purport: since the creation of the material world, everyone has been trying to attain a permanent life. But the laws of nature are so cruel that no one has been able to avoid the hand of death. No one wants to die, nor does anyone want to become old or diseased. The law of nature, however, does not allow anyone immunity from old age, disease, or death. Nor has the advancement of material knowledge solved these problems. Material science can discover the nuclear bomb to accelerate the process of death, but it cannot discover anything that can protect man from the cruel hands of old age, disease, and death. From the Puranas, we learn of the activities of Hiranyakashipu, a king who was very much advanced materially, wanting to conquer cruel death by his material acquisitions and the strength of his nascence. He underwent a type of meditation so severe that the inhabitants of all the planetary systems became disturbed by his mystic powers. He forced the creator of the universe, the demigod Brahma, to come down to him. He then asked Brahma for the benediction of becoming Amara, by which one does not die. Brahma said that he could not award the benediction because even he, the material creator who rules all planets, is not Amara. As confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita 8.17, Brahma lives a long time, but that does not mean he is immortal. Hiranya means gold and Kashipu means soft bed. This cunning gentleman, Hiranyakashipu, was interested in these two things, money and woman, and he wanted to enjoy them by becoming immortal. He asked from Brahma many benedictions in hopes of indirectly fulfilling his desire to become immortal, since Brahma told him that he could not grant the gift of immortality. Hiranyakashipu requested that he not be killed by any man, animal, god, or any other living being within the 8,400,000 species. He also asked that he not die on land, in the air or water, or by any weapon. In this way, Hiranyakashipu foolishly thought these guarantees would save him from death. Ultimately, however, although Brahma granted him all these benedictions, he was killed by the personality of Godhead in the form of Narsimha, the Lord's half-lion, half-man incarnation, and no weapon was used to kill him, for he was killed by the Lord's nails. Nor was he killed on the land, in the air, or in the water, for he was killed on the lap of that wonderful living being, Narsimha, who was beyond his conception. The whole point here is that even Hiranyakashipu, the most powerful of materialists, could not become deathless by his various plans. What then can be accomplished by the tiny Hiranyakashipus of today, whose plans are thwarted from moment to moment? Sri Ishopanishad instructs us not to make one-sided attempts to win the struggle for existence. Everyone is struggling hard for existence, but the laws of material nature are so hard and fast that they do not allow anyone to surpass them. In order to attain a permanent life, one must be prepared to go back to Godhead. The process by which one goes back to Godhead is a different branch of knowledge, and it has to be learned from revealed Vedic scriptures such as the Upanishads, Vedanta Sutra, Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. To become happy in this life and attain a permanent blissful life after leaving this material body, one must study the sacred literature and obtain transcendental knowledge. The conditioned living being has forgotten his eternal relationship with God and has mistakenly accepted the temporary place of his birth as all in all. The Lord has kindly delivered the above mentioned scriptures in India and other scriptures in other countries to remind the forgetful human being that his home is not here in this material world. The living being is a spiritual entity, and he can be happy only by returning to his spiritual home. From his kingdom, the personality of Godhead sends his bona fide servants to propagate this message by which one can return to Godhead, and sometimes the Lord comes himself to do this work. Since all living beings are his beloved sons, his parts and parcels, God is most sorry than we ourselves to see the sufferings we are constantly undergoing in this material condition. The miseries of this material world serve to indirectly remind us of our incapability with dead matter. Intelligent living entities generally take note of these reminders and engage themselves in the culture of vidya or transcendental knowledge. Human life is the best opportunity for the culture of spiritual knowledge, and a human being who does not take advantage of this opportunity is called Naradhama, the lowest of human beings. The path of avidya, or advancement of material knowledge for sense gratification, is the path of repeated birth and death. As he exists spiritually, the living entity has no birth or death. Birth and death apply to the outward covering of the spirit soul, the body. Death is compared to the taking off, and birth to the putting on of outward garments. Foolish human beings who are grossly absorbed in the culture of avidya, nascence, do not mind this cruel process. Enamored with the beauty of the illusory energy, they undergo the same miseries repeatedly and do not learn any lessons from the laws of nature. Therefore, the culture of vidya or transcendental knowledge is essential for the human being. Sense enjoyment in the diseased material condition must be restricted as far as possible. Unrestricted sense enjoyment in this bodily condition is the path of ignorance and death. The living entities are not without spiritual senses. Every living being in his original spiritual form has all the senses which are now materially manifested, being covered by the material body and mind. The activities of the material senses are perverted reflections of the activities of the original spiritual senses. In this diseased condition, the spirit soul engages in material activities under the material covering. Real sense enjoyment is possible only when the disease of materialism is removed. In our pure spiritual form, free from all material contaminations, real enjoyment of the senses is possible. A patient must regain his health before he can truly enjoy pleasure again. Thus, the aim of human life should not be to enjoy perverted sense enjoyment, but to cure the material disease. Aggravation of the material disease is no sign of knowledge, but a sign of avidya, ignorance. For good health, a person should not increase his fever from 105 degrees to 107 degrees, but should reduce his temperature to the normal 98.6. That should be the aim of human life. The modern trend of material civilization is to increase the temperature of the feverish material condition, which has reached the point of 107 degrees in the form of atomic energy. Meanwhile, the foolish politicians are crying that at any moment the world may go to hell. That is the result of the advancement of material knowledge and the neglect of the most important part of life, the culture of spiritual knowledge. Sri Ishopanishad herein warns that we must not follow this dangerous path leading to death. On the contrary, we must develop the culture of spiritual knowledge so that we may become completely free from the cruel hands of death. This does not mean that all activities for the maintenance of the body should be stopped. There is no question of stopping activities, just as there is no question of wiping out one's temperature altogether when trying to recover from a disease. To make the best use of a bad bargain is the appropriate expression. The culture of spiritual knowledge necessitates the help of the body and the mind. Therefore, maintenance of the body and mind is required if we are to reach our goal. The normal temperature should be maintained at 98.6 degrees, and the great sages and saints of India have attempted to do this by a balanced program of spiritual and material knowledge. They never allowed the misuse of human intelligence for diseased sense gratification. Human activities diseased by a tendency towards sense gratification have been regulated in the Vedas under the principles of salvation. This system employs religion, economic development, sense gratification, and salvation. But at the present moment, people have no interest in religion or salvation. They only have one aim in life, sense gratification. And in order to achieve this end, they make plans for economic development. Misguided men think that religion should be maintained because it contributes to economic development, which is required for sense gratification. Thus, in order to guarantee further sense gratification after death, in heaven, there is some system of religious observance. But this is not the purpose of religion. The path of religion is actually meant for self-realization, and economic development is required just to maintain the body in a sound, healthy condition. A man should lead a healthy life with a sound mind just to realize vidya, true knowledge, which is the aim of human life. This life is not meant for working like an ass or for culturing avidya for sense gratification. The path of vidya is most perfectly presented in Srimad Bhagavatam, which directs a human being to utilize his life to inquire into the absolute truth. The absolute truth is realized step by step as Brahman, Paramatma, and finally Bhagavan, the personality of Godhead. The absolute truth is realized by the broad-minded man who has attained knowledge and detachment by following the 18 principles of the Bhagavad Gita described in the purport to Mantra 10. The central purpose of these 18 principles is the attainment of transcendental devotional service to the personality of Godhead. Therefore, all classes of men are encouraged to learn the art of devotional service to the Lord. The guaranteed path to the aim of vidya is described by Srila Rupa Goswami in his Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, which we have presented in English as the Nectar of Devotion. The culture of vidya is summarized in Srimad Bhagavatam 1.2.14 in the following words: Tasmadhekena manasa Bhagavan Satvatampati Srotavya Krita Krititavyascha Dheya Pujyascha Nityada. Therefore, with one pointed attention, one should constantly hear about, glorify, remember, and worship the personality of Godhead, who is the protector of the devotees. Unless religion, economic development, and sense gratification aim towards the attainment of devotional service to the Lord, they are all simply different forms of nascence, as Sri Ishopanishad indicates in the following mantras. Hare Krishna.